Let's see. Here we go. It's about 5 to 2. So let's just quickly go to the text. Let me see. Welcome. Thank you so much. Wonderful to see you. We are going to give everybody about 5 minutes before we get started. So if you're sticking around, if you came here for one reason, you're here today to reclaim the power that we the people have and will always have, and that we can move in a direction that doesn't need some institution, doesn't need some body else to dictate and for we're us to wait and say, oh, yeah, now you can. We're talking bartering today. All right. And anyone that would like to become a guest or would like to join, that's the purpose of this live conversation. We'll have this in 5 minutes time. So if you would be so kind to share it with your network, that would be phenomenal. But if not, that's also fine. What we will be discussing is what you would be prepared to receive as a barter in exchange for whatever it is that you are offering, whether that's a product or a service. And this is definitely not limited to only South Africa. I've been receiving messages from inter-Africa. I've received messages from the UK. It's phenomenal how when you complain, that once somebody else hears the complaint that they themselves have, we can actually hook up. So even though it was out of that chaos, there's going to be beauty in it. Thank you. Welcome, everyone. Let's see. Main O. In it, it's Insemo. Welcome. Adventure with Kyle. Thank you so much for joining. Bye and Sly. Lekker. Welcome. Yesterday. What's that? Carla Jacobs, Western Province. Welcome, Carla. It's great to have you here. I'm sure you're not from South Africa. Zane, welcome. High life, that's great. Have you here, man? Welcome. It's great. Bars price. Welcome, Nika. User clump numbers. Prince Darren. Hi, Ches. Tawa Deskayeza. It's wonderful to have you be here and to be part of this. I'm really hoping that, and remember, titles in whatever house you represent, whatever political part, that stuff is not the reason why you will have an opportunity to speak, but it will be great to finally hear from leaders within all of our communities. And like I said, I've got a lot of people from all over sharing and saying, yo, Etienne, I provide this service. And I've been talking about bartering and wanting to do this for a long, long time. And I'm not one magical, fantastic, super, who I am, if you've never seen my face, is irrelevant. But what is relevant is that you are here and we together, the all of us, are able to have a conversation that should be happening everywhere. The cost of living is out of this world. The cost of existing is even worse. And the thing that bugs me, and I'm sure bugs you, is how is it possible that we are the only creature, species, dung hier op die aarde, that was born here. Remember, you appeared, became aware of your consciousness at a late stage, whatever your period was that you decided that enough is enough, I'm going to think for myself. But we're the only ones that have to pay to be here. No other creatures, no other things within this realm have to pay to be here. And they are doing absolutely fine. Now, before I get started, I would like to... it is almost 2 o'clock. So I'm going to give a lot of the folks that didn't... are waiting for 2 o'clock to jump on. I'm going to give them a chance. I'm going to give you a chance to also say hello. Please let me know where you're from. You can keep your anonymity. As your clump numbers, username, and whatever your name is, that's fine. Keep your anonymity. But it would be wonderful to find out whereabouts in the realm you are connecting with us today. And again, if you are looking to barter and you have a service or product, it's even better to know what you would accept in exchange for whatever your products and services. And the panel is open to everyone. everyone and anyone, if you feel like you would like to speak or you'd like to have an opportunity, please request to be a guest and we will all talk together. This is not about me. This is not about, oh yeah, because this one dude who some people... No, this is about us having a very frank and honest conversation about something that does not need permission. We don't need permission from anyone. You own your skill. You are the creator of whatever it is that you are offering the world. And if you decide, I'm not going to take money for it, I will exchange equal value in terms of bartering, then great. So let me know where you're from. Big love to you, dude. Adventure Kyle. Oh, man. Thank you. Kai Gang Gangs. Jade Hendricks, welcome. Big Beard, welcome. Cafe. I'm assuming you're probably from the UK, right? If a name like Cafe. If it is, welcome. It's great. I've had people from the UK also tell me that, you know, they love to barter. And it's great to have you here. Katlego! Dumelong. I hope you're fantastic. And that's like such a pigeonhole who says that you speak Zulu. Molweni, Kaiches, Dagse, Ciao, Bonjour. All of the languages are important because that's the way you express who you are. And I'm incredibly excited, you can tell, because of you, because you're here. And because of all of your messages and all of your responses and emails and say, yay, why are we doing this? And where can I do this? And how can... And yes, there are question marks. I'm not saying I have the answers. I am not saying this is the way. And what I am saying is we can have this conversation and figure it out together. Let's see. Adventure Kyle, I do residential building plans. Look at that. Phenomenal. Let us know where you're from, Kyle. Whereabouts you are in the realm so that we also... And if you're also jumping in now, welcome. Please let us know where you're from. You don't have to say your name. You don't keep your anonymity. But it would be great to know whereabouts you are from. If you're from the African continent, if you are from any of the other continents, if you are from South Africa, from Kenya, like I mentioned, please let us know. Now, before I jump in, and I know that it's 2 o'clock now, something that I really wanted to share, and again, remember, anyone that is in this conversation can just request. I wish it was just a thing you could just jump in, but if you request, I will add you as a guest, and this is our platform. It's our chance to speak, and whatever it is that you'd like to contribute to the conversation regarding bartering and how we can do this, what your experience is, or if you want to use it as an opportunity to plug, dala, or who's to stop you? Share your skills, share your thing you have to offer. Talk to whom will listen. Before I dive into this conversation and open up the panel, I want to just quickly talk about the bartering system, because I did get a lot of questions around like, yeah, but you can't say, I want food, but I've only got a Ferrari, so let me give you my Ferrari, and then you are going to give me food. Those things aren't the same value. So I just want to quickly give us a bit of background that bartering isn't just something that stems from the Aboriginal people of the Southern African continent. Bartering of indigenous cultures, and this is something you can search. Let me just quickly check my reference list. That you can also go to, so that you, in your own time, you can go and look at. You can look at academic articles regarding trade and exchange in the indigenous North Americas. You can look at Aboriginal trade in Australia by Rise Jones, a journal of indigenous settlers studies. Excuse me. There's a trading practice of Africa by John Booty. Also, beautiful text that you can read. There are general histories of bartering that you can go and look at. Jack Weatherford. And I will add a link to a follow-up video. And when I post this replay on my YouTube, I will also have these references there. But it's not something new. There's been a lot of others that have written about this. The bartering system and the emergence of money in ancient civilizations. Because that's what this is about. We don't need to have money in order to exchange what we've created or what we have to offer for just fiat currency. And then there's also something that's very important that I'd like to discuss in today's session is, how did we transition from bartering to money? And in order to do that, you can look at The Origins of Money in the Roman World by Robert Andrew Glaser. There's also Money and Trade in Early Civilizations by Richard Gombrich. Gombrich. It's probably an Irish name or a Scottish name, and I'm sorry if I messed it up. But you can go look at Money and Trade and the early industries and civilizations. And then there's also the transition to fiat currency in modern economies, research papers from, and this is the one that always causes the issues, from the International Monetary Fund and the World Bank. Because if you understand, you truly understand the Reserve Bank, and there's only 12 or 11, I can't remember how many exactly, I will check my reference, please correct me if I'm wrong, but there's only so many, and South Africa is one of those reserve banks that is allowed to issue currency. And a lot of them are just part of the same banking cartel of the International Monetary Fund and the World Bank. So now let's just quickly talk about the history of bartering. What happened? Where did it come from? Where's the earliest practices? Prehistoric society. In early human history, hunter-gatherers, hunter-gatherers and later agricultural communities traded excess goods such as food, tools, and animals directly with each other. These exchanges were often local, so you don't need to wait for national or for some other body. Locally, it happened, and these exchanges happen directly with each other. There's no middleman, there's no cart machinchi, there's nobody that's saying, oh, listen, you got to pay tax on that. Listen, I know it costs R5, but then there's also that VAT on top of that. It happened between two living men and women that decided. Ancient civilizations in Mesopotamia and Egypt and other ancient civilizations, the bartering system became more organized with marketplaces where people would trade various goods like grain and livestock, textiles and pottery. Because let's quickly fast forward to modern times. Let's say I needed a whole roll, a toilet paper, and now I don't have a whole roll, and I've maybe got a half a sticky chocolate left, and I know my neighbor, I'm like, hey neighbor, listen, can you maybe give me a whole roll? He's like, half a sticky chocolate. He's like, ex-mark, I'll uncle for a sticky chocolate. He's supposed to be a whole roll or something. It was not practical to do this with just one-on-one, so markets were set up. Again, no money, bartering in a marketplace. And ancient civilizations like Mesopotamia and Egypt, they practiced this and used it for textiles and pottery and livestock. Trade routes. Now, this is where it became very interesting, because you in the Western Province, or you in the Eastern Cape, or you in Kenya, or you in the UK or in Australia, wherever it is that you find yourself, what happened was these trade routes that was established, and because I knew in my local, sorry, I won't do the accent, in my local community, we accepted, everybody knew, like in jail, it's like 5 inches, it's like and so full, and 3 inches is equal to that. Those trade routes were being established because some of the services and goods that were available in the local vicinity weren't available, so they went to other areas. And those trade routes were as a result of societies advancing. And like the Silk Road, not the one on the dark web, but like the Silk Road, facilitated this bartering between distant cultures. Silk, spices, precious metals were exchanged between Europe, Asia, and the Middle East. And I'm not saying Africa was not included or any of the other continents, but this is specific to just the background. And if you've just jumped in, please understand the platform for you to come and speak will become available. I just think it's important for us to understand what bartering is and what the history is. Now, the cultural bartering system for indigenous peoples, as I've mentioned before, had complex systems that helped foster both economic and social relationships within and between the tribes. So I'm not promoting tribalism, I'm not promoting separatism. If you're going to talk about that, please see yourself out. We don't have time for that. If you want to have that, there'll be another conversation where you can have that. But we are not looking for anybody that's coming here. We're just, yeah, but we are the First Nation people and we need to be, yes, stand in your power, claim and own who you are and where you come from. But that is not to determine what us as all people should now follow, because now you are separating and excluding people. And look what separation has done for society at the moment. All these indigenous cultures had this complex system that helped them trade so that these trades were happening between and within tribes. Trade was often connected with rituals, alliances, and social structures. Now, here's the last question before we open up the floor, and you can say, Etienne, let me come and speak so we can talk about how do we make this happen? How do we, we're not going backwards. We're not going to be like, oh, so now all of a sudden you want to just throw sticks and stones and put this. No, we're saying we are adults. We are the current, let's say, deciders of how the future of those that are coming after us is going to look. Are they going to have to fix our bullshit, or are they going to be able to carry on building and growing on top of what we were able to fix from our own mistakes? Why did bartering get replaced by fiat currency? And now I know there's practical reasons, but I'm not going to discuss. Let's talk about that. There was double coincidences of wants. Bartering requires that both parties want what the other has to offer. As societies expanded, finding someone who had what you needed and wanted and what you had became a lot more difficult. And that can be said true of our job situation at the moment. I live in a small town in Malmesbury in the West Coast. And if you are looking for employment, it's like, this is a klein dorpie, okay? And as jy by almal ingegooi het, if you don't know who's who and who's where, gaan jy nie werk kry nie. Because, and it's not everybody, so please, just calm down. Not every, but because it's such a small town, there's only so many people that have that skill. There's only so many people that are looking to offer that opportunity. It became difficult. And there was need to now expand and explore. This is the reason why people now develop fiat currency. There was a lack of standardization. I would trade 2 toilet rolls, like I said, for half a sticky chocolate. Sal ek nou 2 whole roller for rail. But you would say, 2 toilet paper rolls for half a chocolate. I want a whole chocolate. That standardization, goods in the bartering system had no standardized value. What you value it as your toilet roll for is not the same value as somebody that drives that wants the toilet roll. And the best example is you have diarrhea. But you spray painting the toilet, right? You have no toilet paper, but you have a Ferrari. The value of the toilet paper I have is the same of that Ferrari because you need that toilet paper right now. But if you don't, and I'm like, give me that Ferrari and I'll give you the toilet roll, you're going to get out of here. So standardizing the value interpreted by each person was part of the reason why fiat currency or currency was made, because no standardized value, making large scale trade very difficult. It was hard to equate the value of diverse products like a goat for a sack of grain or textiles, etc. Storage and the probability of issues that like certain goods used in bartering, such as livestock or perishable foods, were difficult for this purpose. I can't now store, I don't have space for cows, even though I want a cow. I can't store it, so that's an issue for me. And also, when I have to travel a long distance with that I've traded, it becomes a bit of a cumbersome situation. So then the argument is, well, that's the reason why you rather use money. The introduction of commodity money. Early civilizations began to use commodity money like shells and gold and silver as standardized mediums of exchange. Now, this is also very important. These items were durable, widely recognized, and could be stored very easily. So you'd give me 20 shells, and I knew 20 shells would get me half a bag of oranges. It could also get me maybe a third of a cow. It could get me. It was easy to then equate those, the values thereof. The emergence of coins and currencies happened around 600 BCE. The very first coin was minted in the kingdom of Lydia, or modern-day Turkey, where coins made it easier to trade, save wealth, and establish price for goods and services. This innovation spread rapidly across the world. And this was then quickly followed by the trade networks expanding. Economies needed a more efficient system. Paper money emerged in China during the Tang Dynasty. I almost did the accent there. Sorry to my Asian friends, I won't do it. In the 7th century, and was later adopted in Europe. So the Chinese were the ones that gave us paper money, and then it was adopted. Okay, Europe decided to adopt it. Paper money was backed by the commodities like gold and silver, because you can't carry around a lot of gold, even though we were trading gold and silver and shells and whatever. paper money was then saying, okay, here's the paper money that says, I promise, I have this in gold. So when you bring me that paper money to my place, then you can come and get the gold. And this facilitated the change, the exchange and the growth of international trade. Now, fiat currency, this is where the problem that I had, that people are so reliant on only fiat currency. Eventually, governments moved away from money backed by physical commodities and adopted fiat currency. What does that mean, Etienne? That means, unlike in the previous example, you can exchange that sticky puppy and you can come and take the gold if you want to. But in the moment, this piece of paper is a replacement for the gold. And whenever it's necessary, we can still trade. It's easier to fold and whatever. But if you want to come and collect that gold from me, you just bring me the sticky paper and I will give you that gold. The government moved away from money backed by physical commodities and adopted fiat currency. Money that has value by the government's decree. Now, this is where it becomes tricky. This is the leadership. This is where I feel, especially in our own communities, leaders have got to do better. Because the government then decided, all right, it's no longer dependent on how much gold you have or silver or shells or whatever. Now we're going to say, this is a 10-pound note. This is a $10 note. This is a 10-shilling note. This is... Now they decided what that value of that paper was, all right? And because they decided what the money that was valued by the decree of the government, this system, yes, like, I don't know what that is. This system relied on the trust in the government to maintain the currency's value. Now, I'm sure you've heard this word trust be thrown around, especially my Khoi San, Kham people. You've heard this trust. That's the trust where you are saying, I am going to take what you say, government, and I'm going to not need to think about it or believe it. I'm going to know it to be true. Fiat currency has been the global standard since the 20th century, and apparently... And this is my own personal little take. It's now easier. It allows for easier control of your economy. And it helps with the inflation management and standard, which we all know are the tools used in order to keep us poor. Now, if you just jumped in, you're like, what is this guy complaining about? Today's conversation is about one thing and one thing only. For us to discuss, how can we barter in a decentralized local manner. Not to say we are replacing the way things are, because not everybody's going to do it, because too many people are still reliant and are convinced that they can trust the government, can trust their traditional leaders, can trust the community leaders, can trust the banks, can trust everybody that says, no, we are here for your well-being and we want to make sure that the whole country is benefiting and everybody, but just remember you got to pay taxes and we need money for this and you need money for that and we can't do this without that. And oh, listen, we don't have to disclose where we spent this and we don't have to tell you any of this stuff. We are saying, yes, we have fiat currency systems. We understand economics, micro and macro. And we know if you do understand economics, Adam Smith, the father of economics, it is a theory. Just like gravity, just like everything else is a theory. Even the quantum world, a lot of people that will argue is like, yeah, but quantum physics, I'm like, yeah, okay, but it's a theory. In other words, it's just something we can not yet prove. It's a hypothesis. So what I'm asking is, how can we run parallel? And now it's open for you. Please request to join the conversation. I'm going to go and read some of the comments as well and see who has questions or statements or something they want to say. But this is the part where we are actually having this conversation. This is why we're doing this. And I'm going to obviously do this a lot more times. We need to figure out here in Malmesbury, there in insert your place's name, where others who have a like mind that say, look, I get it. I can't pay my rent with my goods and services that I have because they are still dependent on trusting the government, trusting the banks, and trusting. But in my town, there are others who have products and have services that are prepared to barter and exchange what I have either as a product or a service. How can we do that? How do we start doing that? And I think that this is the critical point that we will discuss going forward. So please, again, if you've just jumped in, welcome. It's wonderful to have you here, you beautiful soul. Let us know where you are watching from, where you're joining us from. You don't have to say your name. You can keep your anonymity. But also say what you are looking to trade or barter and in exchange for what you will accept. Let's quickly go to the comments and see wie is nou amal. Yes, like hier's so baie mense wat nou ingespring het en seker maar uitgegaan het. But while I was kekkelekkeling, but let me quickly go check here. Let's see. Go right to the top. And ek wil amal 'n kans gee. And every single one of your voices are important and are valued. So if I don't get to your question in time or don't feel touched, I'm going to get down to the questions and then we will open up and start requesting to join so long, I believe. Here we go. Kathy has joined again. Tipu, so welcome. West Coast Distillers, welcome. Katlego has become number two gifter. Thank you. Millie, welcome. Millie, Natasha, Killer 420. Laugh true. I'm not sure which one it is, but it's all truth. We are only having a true versation here. No conversations. True versations only, please. Welcome, Malcolm Reddy. Right the wach in the hills. We've already got a residential building plan person, and that's Adventures with Kyle. He does building plans. All the way from MP in Witbank. Witbank Vusi Valve. Welcome. It's wonderful to have you here. Witbank is a lekker place. I did some comedy there before. You guys are wild. I'm not going to even lie. Killer420, thank you for the likes. Coco joined. Let's see. John Seconds has joined. Let's see. Enige vragies. Okay, ek sien nou, hier's obviously people that joined and jumped off. Let me quickly go to Puff Tone. Sylvia. I'm so glad to see you. Greetings. So wonderful to have you here. Lenwabo. Humbule, welcome. Man, I'm probably mispronouncing it. Mainly, thank you. I'm glad you joined us and you made it. Henry Klaassen, 105. Hey, Etienne. How's it, Henry? Hoe gaan het met jou? Hoe gaat het met hom? Nwabi joined. Devesh joined. Let's see. Questions or comments. Sovereign Wolf, welcome. Thank you for your email as well. I hope you received my response and that you also joined the group. For yesterday's live that we had on common law for common folks. Also, a very big reminder, tonight there is the General Assembly talking about law, talking about your birth certificate, and these are experts in legalese, in law, in the emancipation process. Please, the link is in my on my website. If you go to my profile and click on it, it's the first one. You tap on it and you go straight to the Zoom call and it's all for free. Storm, what's up, my brother? Yes! Hi, cheers. I know we missed each other last night while I was looking after my son, but I'm glad that you made it today. Glad to see you on live again. We're here to learn and do better together. That's the attitude and the mindset and the departure point that we are having this truversation with. We are not looking to ruffle feathers. I know there's lots of things that are maybe also important to discuss, and I think we'll leave the last portion of our conversation for that, or our truversation for that. But what we are focusing on definitely is how do we make this bartering thing work? What is a way that we can figure out that this will work? Yes, like so many likes and shares. Thank you so much. Are you taking time banking into consideration? That's a very good question, Sovereign Wolf. Maybe if you can clarify that for me, if you mean the time value of money and interest, because if we look at the religious texts, or if I like to consider them the allegorical, let's say, educational documents, interest should not exist. There should not be interest, period. How the freaking hell can, if there's only 100 of whatever your currency is in the entire economy, and I come and loan it from you, how am I paying interest when there's only 100 of whatever the currency in the economy? Where did that other money come from? Created out of thin air. That's what these banks are doing and what the bankers are doing. And that's why interest is, and this is also for my Judeo-Christian people, the reason why JC went into those places and was saying, yeah, you're making a mockery and don't do this, is because it creates slavery. Interests create slaves. So I think if that's what you're referring to, Sovereign Wolf, time banking, I am taking that into consideration in terms of why I don't want to do fiat currency and why I prefer bartering instead. And instead of time, I'd rather take expiration date. Don't give me a potato that's going to be like 17 potatoes if I plant it that's ready. I want to eat it now. And that's where the value and honor and integrity and honesty, all the things that a lot of people just use the word for, and I say people because I don't want to single out any individual group or organization, but that's what a lot of people hang on to, is they just use those words and say, no, but I'm going to honor this, I'm going to do. You have to act in honor to be honored. You have to be respectful to be respected. Storm, you can never trust the government. The reason why I agree with this, Storm, is because let's take one very simple example. Of all the money that's available to be spent, yes, we need to have defense. Yes, we need to have other things and exploratory research. Why can we not prioritize the basic needs, the fundamental building blocks of a strong economy, education, and spend that money there first? Why can't we then say that the agenda that these people have, regardless of who's sitting in what office, by what term of voting or whatever, is always the same for the betterment of all people? But instead, it's like, yeah, no, those guys fang kakan, and now we're going to do it better because we are not going to focus on this, we're going to focus on that. That's where my problem with trusting the government or anybody that dictates to you or prescribes to you what to do. You as a sovereign, you create the law. You create the law for yourself. And the main laws that you abide by are universal laws, which do no harm unto others. That's like one of the first ones. And the original Ten Commandments, not the remixed version. let's see. Eno from Stellenbosch. Welcome, Stellenbosch. And yes, like back in the day when I was to take a lot of dopes when I was still in my first year. Stellenbosch is a rover plek geweest. Ewan August, blessed love to all. Ewan August, blessed love. Be more love, because you're not less. So don't be less. More love. Be moreing to you, man. I'm a permaculture and soil microbiology practitioner. Sovereign Wolf, fantastic. Now that is the number one thing everybody, I don't care what your opinion is, that is something everybody needs to know about. And something I will share with everyone during the tail end of this conversation is how we can make most use of the current digital environment in order for you to still provide this information, provide this insight, and give people, equip people with the ability to take care of themselves and be sovereign, but then still generate income from places like this platform, from places like YouTube, from places like whatever the other digital platforms and social media platforms you're. We'll talk about that, because not everybody's going to pay for your permaculture and soil microbiology services. They're going to be like, oh, that's just something I'm going to need. I've got to prioritize. I'll rather go buy my stuff. But if they teach a man to fish and he'll eat forever, that's exactly what we're talking about. Yuan is a financial advisor. Now, this is also wonderful because this is the type of person that can help you who is in the current fiat economic system, this debt slave system. Let's not try to sugarcoat this. It's a debt slave system. Here's somebody that can give you true and proper advice on how to navigate this. It's not a silver bullet. It's not a magic wand. It's not a genie. Oh, it's a blief, let all my skills weggaan. This is a way to systematically, stelselmatig, through change of habits in self to prevent it from happening again, but dealing with it now and starting to make sound financial decisions. I got a comment from somebody saying, yeah, you're talking about bartering. Hoe gaan ek nou gaan barter for petrol? How many people produce fuel? How many people can then say, okay, you can't buy fuel. I've got a donkey car and ek is op route. And Jay is op my route. Ik heb jou lief gee. There's your problem solved. Don't always just assume that the way things are is the only way it can be. Sovereign Wolf says, thank you. True. Will do. Appreciate, love that, man. Any thoughts on Nursa and you and interest that spawned out of greed of man. You are 100%. I think I would love you to join us. I there are very many people on the thing request to be a guest, and I'd love for you to and this is open to everyone. Anyone watching right now, you can request to be a guest, and we are guests together to everyone that's listening, and we can share our story. You can share your opinion, your view. We're having a true conversation. So if you could enlighten us a little bit more, and we can get a feel of what this is, and also an understanding for those that might not know, that would be helpful. Value exchange, sovereign wealth, value exchange. I'm spending 2 hours gardening, and in return, you spend 2 hours marketing. Perfect example. Perfect example. And let's just take it another step further. Let's say, for example, like everybody's selling digital courses now. And I'm not saying that you need to sell a digital course in order for you to, but let's say you develop a digital course, a beginner's guide to permaculture and what was it? Soil microbiology. And it's a $2 course or a $3 course or a $5 course. You now provide that 2 hour gardening service to me. I will then not only do the marketing of your services that you can go and do the gardening for others in exchange for bartering, but then my duty, acting in honor, is then to say, here is a way for you to utilize this current system to benefit and leverage to expand, number one, how many people you can share this knowledge with. Number two, equip you to expand your capacity to teach more people and equip more people. Maybe you can do live classes at schools now, but we know that you need to get there and you can subsidize that through selling this course. It's my duty as a marketer, as somebody that understands the digital realm, to then share that with you and build it out with you. And that is the equal value. We're not just exchanging time. Like, that's the thing that things are working now. It's time for money. That's what work is. You exchange your time for money. But we're talking about the value that you have to offer, the value you have in you, that is the only value that is attached to that money. That's what we are talking about. So that's a beautiful example. Time banking principle, exchange of time-based services where all hours are valued equally. Oh, that's exactly, yeah, that's what you mean. So yeah, Sovereign Wolf, please, I'm waiting for your for your thing to say, KK Ekwalok joined, so you can be on the panel. I'd love to hear from you. Let's explore that a little bit further. Storm says, basic human needs are never met by the government in order to maintain the oppression they enforce, because they operate with duress. They want to make sure that you feel as if you cannot function on your own without a piece of paper or a signature of someone you've never met in a place that they will never set foot on. And a perfect example, when one of my first tasks I took on in Malmesbury when I was initiated, when I completed my ngau in the Kokokwa house as the Aboriginal Indigenous Khoi leader here in Malmesbury, my first task was to take the individuals. There's a lot of wood makers. The history behind the people is they made wood. Because I have a network that spans across wide because of you, because you are part of that network, all of you, I was able to say, okay, all of us are sitting at home, unemployed. You can chop wood. You can identify the trees that we need to cut down. You're the one that's got the experience in terms of the way that this market operates. Let's set up a network of, let's first start with a group here. Let's go into the forest and let's chop some wood and provide the wood to our community first, so that we can then in exchange provide for our family and then grow on top of that to then expand. The first thing that the municipality told me is, you need a permit. I'm like, a permit? For what? No, you can't just cut down trees. I'm like, I'm not just cutting down trees. We are removing invasive species. We are taking the same trees that have been standing there for years that you guys will end up going through the tender process and saying, oh, not this one and that one. But anyway, you have your friend that you're going to give it to anyway, to then cut down. And then you're only going to do a sticky and they're going to run out of money. And then you're going to do this and all that. We are skipping all of that bollocks, removing those invasive alien species plants, providing an opportunity for somebody to work who's sitting at home waiting for something instead of waiting for something, now can actually do something about it. And in the same breath, spreading
the commodity or the resource outside of our community, bringing more attention into Malmesbury, saying, hey, ek het nie geweet Malmesbury is hulle dog die ook nie, wat anders het julle, instead of just driving past us on the N7. No, you need a permit. Who gave you permission? I'm a former ward carrier. I'm like, yay. And immediately what they do is distress. If you don't have a permit, you will go to jail. So this is why I don't trust them. This is why I feel that the government and all these other authorities and people that are supposed to look after us don't do that. They prioritize gaining and maintaining control over you so that they can decide when to switch on and off your water. They can decide when and where, just like in COVID, where all of a sudden all our rights were removed under fear. And now when all the research is coming out, everybody that was told they're crazy and everybody said, no, why would the government lie to us? You mustn't be a causer of the problem. Go take your vaccine. Now the research is coming back and I'm a chup still. All the people that were crazy before, conspiracy theories, are now being backed up by scientific imperial evidence saying that the vaccines caused more damage than they did good. So I can't trust them. I can trust you. If you act in honor and in righteousness and out of respect and in truth, because I can see you, I know you, not them. I don't think they want our basic rights at all. Sovereign Wolf says, I believe so as well. It is a key ingredient to break away and become independent. Primaculture, 100%. If you don't know how to grow your own food, forget about it. Forget about it. The price of a tomato, an onion, the price of eggs. You remember what that price did? They say apparently it's going to do the same thing with the potatoes because of black frost. Have you planted potatoes? Do you know when to plant? Do you know what soil to use? Do you know what you can? No. Do you use the free resources on every platform that's available? Not really. I'd rather use it to watch some stuff. You know, I've got a tough life. I've got other things and I've got work or whatever. 20 minutes to learn about permaculture. You won't do that. 20 minutes spent in the garden, taking a picture of the plants that's there to just learn. What is this? It's not just grass. It's not just a plum tree. It's not this. What does this do? We don't do that because we now have to give our trust to someone else who has that knowledge, who you don't know, who you don't really understand, but that you're just going to say, okay, I might do it. Close your eyes, go under the knife for a doctor you've only had in consultation. He's going to cut you open now and trust him to do the thing. Why can't you trust the same person that's saying, I will give you this knowledge in exchange for this as a barter? Manly, living righteously, truth. I believe so as well. The key ingredient to break away is permaculture. Riaz is true. Thank you, Riaz. Hey, cuz. Oh, Zena all the way from Kitmans in Namibia. Lieflik. I'm glad to see Namibia is also here. Wonderful. Wonderful to have you here, my cousin. Lots of love to you and the family. Stuur goed aan vir ouma ook. Ek hoop jy kan so wys hom vir ouma. Laat ek vir ouma kan hallo sê. Ons mis vir jou, maar jy moet sien hoe groot is jou agterkleintjie. Die kind raak groot. 6.45 kg net van die kitty melk. No name. City pays a lot of on tenders and I've seen it. They have money to uplift the community. Ward councillors are perfect prefects that didn't make it in. Wait, hold on. No name. Ward councillors are prefects that didn't make it in life. Then me as a traditional leader, I must be a head boy that didn't make it in. But I love your sentiment and I agree with you. I've seen some of these tender documents back when I was working for, I won't name the company, but we were specifically focusing on water meters and electricity meters and updating financial management systems from the books to electronic systems and whatever. And I still feel guilty for the part I played in the Eastern Cape. And this is not to say I was responsible directly, but I know I hold my responsibility because I had a job. And the only reason I was doing it was because I was trying to keep food on the table. And that was my way of using my skill and selling myself. That was me prostituting myself to a private company. I still have guilt around my responsibility for all those automatic meter readers where people have the ability to sit in an office. And because you didn't pay your water bill, press a button. Haas jou krag af. Tot jy alle outstanding fees betaal. Haas jou water af. Jylle klaar nog. Druk 'n knoppie. But I know completing those tender documents, being at those tender briefings, having been awarded tenders, or not me being awarded, but the company I work for, and then having to execute, do the work, I know these places have money. And their priority is not to solve the problem. Their priority is to ensure that they can again repeat the cycle. So you are 100% correct, Nomad Name. And I say that out of experience that I've done this. Let's see, who's this? Storm saying, absolutely, 100%. It's all about control. A proud conspiracy theorist over here. I don't trust the system because the system doesn't have anything to do with trust. It's all about control. Dankie, Zenaid, dat jy vir ouma gaan sê. Liefie jou ouma. Spartan, afternoon. Are you aware of the meeting this weekend? Wow. Not too sure, Spartan, which one you are referring to. There are tons of meetings that are happening. Even one tonight, specifically with the SA Jural Assembly, where they will be sharing details on the law, birth certificates, emancipation. There's a whole bunch. You can find it in my profile. It's my website, etiendavids.online. You'll find it's the first one. It will take you directly to the Zoom call for tonight. I think it starts at 7 p.m. South African time. So Spartan, if you can please elaborate. Nazli Lekay, awesome topic. Wake the masses up that is still asleep. Most of the population don't even know. Nazli, you know what I realized? Something I saw on a video before. The reason why everybody is chasing a dream is because we are still asleep. And you were, one of my very first mentors when I was at school told me, "Hey, Butaiki, I used to sell, not earthworms, silkworms. I used to fold paper airplanes in primary school and I sold those. I used to sell, man, whatever it was, I'd find a way. I don't know. I've always had that entrepreneurial spirit in me. I'm sure it's from my ancestors who were trading with many people all over because I'm a descendant of the Namakoi people. Bondelswarze particular. And I think that spirit in me has always been entrepreneurial, solving problems and connecting people to things. And even at that time, my mentor in primary school was saying, if you're going to continuously chase money, you're going to get tired. Stop chasing money. You should be aiming at wealth and creating it. So, Nazli, you're 100% correct. We need to wake each other up, and it starts by being the example, showing what we speak about. Of wat die ander antwoord mag sê, "Ooh, asseblief, Boeta, jy klaar net hoor. Ag, Jesuslank, jy's so pragtig. Jy's so mooi mens. Ek love jou. Ek love jou. Maar jy klaar baie. Tannie, ek klaar nie net nie. Ek doen iets ook daaraan." And that's the main key, Nazli. We got to not just talk and point fingers like what these political parties and some of these leaders do. We have to say, that's an injustice. And this is what we're going to do to fix it. And then show you are doing it so that we can make the change. Durban poison, please. Mental boy. Not too sure what you are referring to. Probably because of the dreadlocks, because everybody just assumes that if you have dread, you must be a Rasta. But Bushmen have, and not just Bushmen, lots of ancient cultures, especially in Africa, have dreads. What's to come with digital currency and more jabs and more scare tactics? 100% correct. I'd love to have your opinion, remember. Ask to be a guest. Ek wag vir julle. Oh, here's a guest already. Sovereign Wolf. I'm going to quickly the last one. 9th annual meeting of the New Development Bank. Sovereign Wolf, 1 second. I'll be with you in 1 second. Nazi, correct. We need to leave the cities in order to live organic life. That's also true. So they will be giving us the jab through the meat and chicken. Woo! He's klom goed wat die ekom. Putting the electric to current is currency. Sovereign Wolf, hi Chess, Tawades Kayeza. Greetings, love, respect, welkom.
Hi, bye, thank you. My name genoot, by the way.
Yeah, oh, Etienne is most the kwaiste naam. Das net elke Etienne wat ek ken. Exactly! Dis moes die regte manier, asseblief. Laat ons nou nie die ander manier is. Etienne, welkom en dankie vir jou tyd vandag, man, en ook vir jou boodskap. Kan jy dalk 'n bietjie met ons deel? Wat het jy om te deel vandag?
My vriend, ek is hier om te leer by jou. Ek volg jou nou al 'n geruime tydjie. Ek volg jou op YouTube en ek is so beïndruk met jou kennis en ek is al 8 jaar op hierdie paadjie van sovereignty. Ek het nie ID nie, ek het nog nooit met hulle gestem of enige van daai dinge nie. So ek vereenselwig myself nie met die staat of met die society waaronder ons onderhewig is nie. En die paadjie wat jy stap is baie in lyn met wat ek doen, so en jou ethos ook. Ek love jou, so ek is hier om te leer en te luister.
Oh, baie dankie man, en alle eer, want ek glo dit is uit ons voorbeeld wat ander leer. Ek het dit met my kind geleer, my meisiekind is nou 5. Ek kan maar hoeveel keer sê, moenie so maak nie, moenie so doen nie, maar dan vang ek haar soms en vang, waar het jy dit geleer? Dan is dit omdat sy gesien het wat ek doen, nie net geluister het wat ek sê nie. So jou voorbeeld is so fenomenaal en ek is so dankbaar dat jy braaf genoeg is om die pad te stap. As ek vir jou iets kan vra vir iemand wat ook, want ek is ook dankbaar, ek leer self, ek weet daar is baie wat ek ook graag wil ander gee en leer wat ek ook maar geleer het, maar iets wat ek graag by jou wil vra is, met die 8 jaar wat jy op hierdie stap was van soewereiniteit, as jy van dag 1 af, as jy kon in 'n time machine inklim en terug gaan na dag 1 toe, en jy kon vir jouself sê, okay, Etienne, hier is 'n moorse challenge wat voor jou staan. Wat is 3 goed wat jy graag vir jouself sou wou sê, wat jy wens, jy daai tyd geweet, wat jy nou weet?
Sjoe,
Nie veel op die sport te sit nie, nee, like after you ask the question.
Ek dink my grootste enigste regret op hierdie stadium is die verhoudings en die mense wat ek langs die pad moes los op hierdie stappie. Dit vat baie, veral van waar ek vandaan kom. Dis nie deel van my kultuur of my familie se kulture nie. So ek moes van die hand maak van daai goeters. Soos hulle sê, my white privilege van die hand wys. En nederig raak, en maar soos ek sê, dit is van die goedjies wat ek mis, maar daar's soveel meer blessings wat gekom het op die pad as gevolg daarvan dat ek kan nie terugkyk nie. Dit is moeilik, dis 'n harde pad om weg te maak. En dis ook persoonlike keuse om vir my bankrekening ontslae te raak en te deregister en al daai goedjies. Ek sukkel, ek kan nie 'n inkomste verdien nie. Ek het geen manier om monetary value to exchange weer vir iets nie. So en dis 'n taak wat ek vir myself aangevat het, en dit is 'n moeilike pad, ek weet dit, maar ek doen dit want ek kan nie myself ter harte kry om weer die persoon te raak wat dit nodig is om te wees om te survive in die ekonomie waarin ons lewe nie. You have to be a very bad person, and I can be a very bad person. I don't want to.
Oh yeah, and that takes a lot of courage to admit, because that's something that I think we shy away from. Ons is so bang, en almal wil altyd, en iemand het my ook, het 'n content creator gesien wat sê, al die influencers, hulle het nooit 'n slegte experience, alles is net pragtig en dit gaan net goed. Maar dis dieselfde soos wat ons ook die blinkkant bo hou, ons amper vermy die ander gedeelte, maar binne in elkeen is dan nog steeds the duality of daai selle, kan ons maar die woord demoon gebruik, is in it's in all of us, maar as jy hom so een kant toe stoot, is dit nie dat hy die pad uit gaan of sy die pad uit gaan nie, jy gee hy of haar meer krag. En dit is courage om te admit dat dit is lelike persoonlikheid of persoonlikhede eienskappe wat jy moet hê om in hierdie stelsel te werk, want dit is al wat gaan werk, wat hulle sal aanvaar. En dit is nie maklik nie, vir alles jy probeer om selfstandig te wees. Iemand gaan jou konstant aanvat en sê, nou maar, hoekom gaan jy nog steeds aan? Hoekom sukkel jy nou nog steeds? Jy kan mos nou net 1, 2, 3 vinnig, as jy nou net gaan re-register, of as jy net, dan sal hy jou terugvat, dan is jou lewe weer makliker. Dink aan jou kinders. Die antwoord wat ek kan van jou af voel, is, ek doen dit, omdat ek nie net aan my kinders dink nie, ek dink aan al die kinders.
Amen, amen.
So ek is baie dankbaar vir jou, man. Jo, wat die kant is jy, as ek mag vra, wat die kant van die...
Heidiglik in Brackenfell, ek beweeg redelik rond, ek hoop om in November weer Genadendalse kant toe te staan, maar ons sal sien, ek travel so 'n bietjie rond seisoenlik, en werk op plaas. Ek doen hierdie woofing en so, ek doen volunteer werk op plaas om, om tuine te bou en so aan.
Prachtig, prachtig. Etienne, ek is so dankbaar vir jou. Ek dink daar's 'n paar goedjies wat ek met jou definitief wil deel. En as jy nog 'n bietjie, ek seker jy sal so lank as wat jy kan vir hierdie sessie, aan die einde van vandag en ek goed deel wat ons spesifiek kan gebruik op hierdie platform, hoe ons inkomste kan verdien en mense kan jou ondersteun wat like-minded is. Dit is nie te doen met hoeveel followers jy het of net deur die ding wat ons elke dag in elk geval doen, scroll, 'n likeetjie gee, 'n kommentjie gee, wat 'n verskil kan maak in terme van jou buying power, so te sê, sonder 'n bankrekening. So ek is baie dankbaar dat jy dit genoem het, and anyone that's hearing, or anybody that's listening and watching, if you're in the Brackenfell area, and you're in need of somebody to come and assist you, vir al die Genadendal mense, ek gaan vir Gammie ook in die hande kry, as jy daai kant...
Ek is goed met Gammie.
Oh, fantastic! Okay, fantastic. Nee, dan is jy mos uitgesort dat jy kan. Ek sê, maar dis goed. Dis goed. Almal wat enige kontak of met Etienne wil maak, nie die Etienne nie, die ander mooie Etienne, let me know. Stuur vir my e-pos of stuur vir my inbox en dan kan ek oordra die boodskap. Asseblief, ons gaan alleenlik 'n verskil kan maak as ons buite onsself ons self-interest kan kyk en sien dat my medemens help. Help ek ook myself. So dankie vir jou storie deel, man. Regtig.
En ek wil vir jou bysê dat een van die grootste blessings wat ek op hierdie 8-jaar ekspedisie van my met weg van die finansiële wêreld af beweeg het, is juist daai. Die value wat jy terugkry by mense, wanneer jy vrylik gee sonder expectation, is soveel meer as wat enige geldwaarde ooit kan wees. En as mense dit eers kan begin besef, the value, the true value that you can create, want wat het jy ook jou forceer om te doen is, dit forceer jou om iemand se behoefte raak te sien en dit op te los, eerder as om geld te probeer verdien uit iets wat jy vir iemand kan doen. And it forces you to develop skills in all aspects, so dat jy meer probleme kan oplos vir ander. Definitely. So dit werk.
Oh, prachtig, dankie vir jou deel, en ek hoop jy het 'n prachtige dag verder, man.
Ek luister verder, en ja, sien hy daarna.
Prachtig, dankie man Etienne. Just like Etienne, net soos Etienne, kan enige een net vir my sê, Etienne, I'd like to be a guest, or click the knoppie to become a guest, and you'll be able to join. Ek is nou nie seker hoe die paneel goedjies werk nie, so ek dink as ek hierdie knoppie druk, yes. I'll say, okay, so like that, that's how I can, then you can come on, share your story, share what you've got to say. The priority that we're trying to get at this is to figure out how we can barter. I know a lot of what we spoke about today was a lot of the reason why and the background, but it's not going to stop here. Ons gaan nie nou vandag sommer net, okay, ja, ek het nou lekker 'n paar views gekry en alles is nou daar. Miskien is nou on to the next one. We cannot lose our stamina just because of the fact that it's difficult. 8 years! Ag, kan jy vir jou indink wat sal gebeur as jy vandag besluit, ek gaan nie meer my bankrekening gebruik nie. Ek gaan nie meer... It's tough! Because everything, the way the world and society set up, is for you to comply. It's for you to comply. If you don't comply, word jy gemaai. And this is where I feel the problem lies. Because just like Etienne said, the true value is in you. Dink aan jou baas, dink aan jou werk, dink aan die, tot jou sportspan. Yes, ons het al die manne, 24 of 23 manne nodig om een rugby span vol te maak. Maar as jy een ou wat nie vleel is nie, een ou wat nie scrum half is nie, somebody that isn't, then it doesn't matter how many other players there are, that one person's value for that one thing, ach, hy kan nie scrum half is nie, hy is maar nie te vleel, that one, that's your value. Without you, the system will collapse. And we're not saying anarchy must reign and alles moet uit mekaar uitval. There is an alternative, and the alternative is we can do it.
We don't need permission. Somebody asked me, ja, Etienne, jy's baie gevaarlik met die goed wat jy sê. You are going to cause problems here. You can't tell people they don't need money and they shouldn't. They need money to survive. I'm like, well, I understand that there's maybe a little sense of sensationalism here, because I'm sure you can even sense my energy, because baie opgecharged, and especially when I connect with you, that gives me that hope that I'm not alone. It helps me realize that, you know, all these things that are existing in my thoughts that will materialize and manifest in this realm, it's not just me. The issue I have with people that say, oh, it's dangerous for you, I always find it that argument is based around the idea that da is nie iets anders nie. Like we learned at the beginning of this conversation, ancient civilizations, before there was money, before there was gold-backed currency, were bartering. And if that is the foundation of us being able to connect on this technological advancement, wherever it is that you're in the world, never before has the entire world fit in the palm of your hand. Never before has anything that you have to share or anything that you want to learn been accessible instantly like that. But it had to come from somewhere. That foundation of those, what did they say? You know, those cave-dwelling, don't know anything. It started there. I'm not saying we need to go back into the Stone Age. What I am saying is we can rely on ourselves and we don't need permission from anyone else. And he was saying it's dangerous because you're going to cause people to go and be ridiculous when they go and they have debts to pay. What I'm saying is we can only make the change one step at a time. We cannot erase, like with my heritage and the people from my background. Ons gaan nie 400 jaar se colonization. It's even longer than 400 years. We aren't going to erase that in one meeting. We're not going to erase that in one piece of legislation. It's not going to happen because one king, queen, whatever your title. It's not going to happen overnight. My favorite expression is, and this is something I've learned and if you're a digital creator or an entertainer, I come from that background as well, stand-up comedy and that. And one thing I always loved hearing is, I became a success, a famous overnight. It's fantastic. It only took 10 years. It takes time. The same way that you can't have an instant meal, how much more value is that for your body when you put something into your body that you spent the time foraging for, like what Etienne, I'm sure you've done. You've done the foraging thing. You've done the growing my own food, like Sovereign Wolf does. Kyle does. You find that satisfaction is so much more than frieting a fast takeaway that makes you feel like you just constipated. Sorry, ek wil net kak praat oor kak praat hier, maar thank you for sharing. Remember, anyone can join this conversation. I think we've still got I've got another 5 minutes before it's 3 o'clock. So then another 20 minutes before I'll end this conversation, and we'll carry on again in another one. But I want to quickly check some of the questions. And also, if you'd like to join, please feel free. The 9th annual meeting of the New Development Bank. I'm not too sure about that. So Natalie, if you'd like to please connect with me and ask to join. Tanieti. Yes, maar die is nou mos 'n handsome man. Yes, like Tanieti. Hoekom moet jy nou dit sê? Maar my wife, she liked it, then she put a ring on it. En hier is my vrou. Daar's my vrou ook. So ek is gevat, Tannie. Sorry, Tannie, hierdie mooi man het klaar vir daar so sê. Daar's my queen. Ek wear my queen met trots, want ek is hane en nie sy is myne nie. They've already poisoned our food sources, hence the reason we are having so many health issues. I want to hammer this point home. I know you don't have land. I know you don't have maybe all of the fancy equipment. Just start to learn. With the offcuts of the carrots and the sticky potatoes and whatever, to see how to take it from there and grow it. From the seeds. My father had this wonderful thing that he used to teach me. My father's a pastor. Yes, he is a pastor. And I'm sure we don't see eye to eye with a lot of things. But my father taught me many, many beautiful things. And one of the things that I loved that he taught me was that in a seed is an entire orchard. That one seed, that one apple seed, is an entire orchard. And that in itself, if you can understand and overstand that, al het jy net 'n paar saaitjies van die green peppers, even if you've only got a couple of seeds from the watermelon that you've got, and maybe it's not seasoned, store it. That's the bank we should be creating. That's the bank that we should put our energy and focus into, is a seed bank in every community. Every community should have a seed bank. And once you start practicing, soos op skool met die boontjie rank, met die cotton wool, as jy nou so bevoorreg was soos wat ek was, om na 'n model C skool toe te gaan en al die goedjies, we were taught how to grow a boontjie rank. And why don't you do it at home? Because the moment that it becomes available, that someone says, I have land, kom knoflokskraal toe. I have land, kom kleikieskraal toe. I have land, kom mamri toe. You have the inherent knowledge and you can start to produce your own food. And when you can produce your own food, it's not about producing it to sell. It's about being able to build the cells healthy and strong, resilient, so that you can continue on with this journey and live life, not just be alive. Kom ons kyk gou. Well done in living your truth, Sovereign Wolf. Daar sê lekker Felicia Butler. Hi Chess Etienne, ek like jou gesels. Ek glo ook in bate, glo ook om te leer. Felicia, gang, ek is so dankbaar dat jy ook by is. En as jy graag enige iets het wat jy wil bate, of wat jy miskien na op soek is om te bate en in verhuil met iets, please sê dit in die comments. Hierdie gemeenskap groei verskriklik vinnig. And still people send emails, and for those that have my private number, are sending me messages, and I know we need to get to a place where this market, like what we learnt, will happen and it will be independent, not be in control by some person. Ek het net gesê, hy moet eers van daai plek. No. We the people have the power, and the people will have that ability to continue to trade fairly, because the moment that someone else has to then give you the green light and do this, that's where we not subjugate ourselves, but we allow ourselves to be controlled, and transparency goes out the window. Van ewe skielik becomes it need to know, and you don't need to know. So please share what you have so that whoever sees it can be like, I'm going to connect with you. And please, anyone that does read the comments and see, oh, there's a person that's building that does building plans, connect with the people in honor, respect, and communicate in truth. Have true conversations. Be open. Kiki, I can only exchange this. Don't think that the value of whatever you're going to barter is connected to the same system that's keeping us in slavery. So Felicia, bye bye, dankie dat jy by is. Plasma event, money is an electric current, currency, where you put and deplete all your energy. Plasma event, 100%, because every single human being is in any case an electromagnetic charged or has an electromagnetic torus field that is impacted by, just like in the Bible it says, as above, so below, by all energies. And that's the reason why when you go to court, they charge you. And that's the reason why when you are sentenced, you go sit in a cell. Oh, where have I heard the cell? Not just from Dragon Ball Z, the battery cell. Because it is about energy. Because energy cannot be destroyed. Energy cannot be created. It can only be transformed. And energy was always there. And I know a lot of people are going to have a problem with this, but dark energy is not what they made you believe it is. These hobgoblins and scary bedtime stories, it's bollocks to keep you from the truth. Face your shadow, face your demons, and you will quickly realize, you will quickly realize that there's a lot more fear-mongering than truth in some of the stories you've heard. Thank you for sharing, Plasma Event. I'm comfortable being the villain. Storm, I love it. I'm comfortable being the villain if that's who I need to be to fight for freedom and justice. Storm, you remind me of my friend Robin. He's exactly the same. What did Batman say? Sometimes the hero has to become the villain. Or was it Two-Face that said it? Wonderful. We put value on money. We are the value that money extracts or extrapolates. 100% Plasma. What if everything collapsed today? That's a question I ask myself every morning. What if today's that day? that everything I've read, everything I've heard, everything that somebody's taught me or that I've discovered, what if it becomes a reality tomorrow? How prepared, number one, am I for my family, as the head of my family? How prepared am I? And number two, what is going to happen to all those who are still chasing that dream because they like to be asleep? So if everything has to collapse today, one of my favorite thought experiments is if the electric grid, electricity, like what we've experienced here in South Africa with load shedding, and I'll close this thought and then I'll read some comments and then I'll give a last opportunity for somebody to join in, and then I will give my last little piece of insight on the digital marketing, and then we will move on to our next session. But if the electric grid, like what we've experienced in load shedding, and a lot of businesses were complaining, like, oh, we're losing money and this is happening, our stuff is going. If the electricity goes off tomorrow and it doesn't come back in 3 days, in 5 days, in 3 weeks, in 2 months, in 8 months, in 1 year, are you going to be comfortable sitting and waiting and thinking it's going to come on tomorrow? Are you going to be capable of dealing with the result that you have no way of impacting, switching the power back on for everybody, that's on your life because you're waiting for something to happen? Is that the kind of life you are putting your chips in the basket for? And do you think that that is worthwhile? If you answered no to any one of those questions, your duty, your task is to liberate and emancipate your mind first, because everything exists that is in existence started as a thought wave, a light particle. What is that particle? A photon. Messaging particle as a wave, and when someone observed it, it collapsed. Everything starts as a thought and it manifests itself. If you are able to, if you answered no to any of those, you need to start changing what is influencing your thoughts. Emancipate your mind, emancipate your thoughts, free yourself, know yourself, search for yourself, look for the kingdom, meet yourself, be honest with yourself, and then start taking the actions that you are going to hear from yourself, not from me, from anyone else, that are true in giving you a way to live and not just be alive. I see a couple more comments. Growing food is more important at this moment. Exactly. 100% plasma. People are too relaxed. 100%. The change starts with you. That is no doubt. The change starts. I lost the comment now. Oh, near. I was going to say, the change starts with you. Sovereign Wolf, yes, we can. The plant is now connected and knowledge is free to all. Education over qualification. 100%. Let's see. Exactly. Not a money bank. A seed bank. Yes, a seed bank is worth more than gold. Yes. Kletjies kraal, wag vir almal. Spartan, what is your profession? Nie om dom te wees nie. Om soeverein te wees. En om te lewe, want ek is lewe. Fantastic. Seed banks. I think that's where we will start. And I'm assuming a lot of you are agreeing with me and we will continue this conversation, but that's where we need to start. With our bartering exchange and how's it going to work and all of that, let's start with how do we build seed banks, connect with the people in your community. Let's talk together then, even if we're far from each other, how do we then help each other to establish those seed banks? That is the way we go forward. Die tyd vir plant is nou. Amase, Spartan. Plasma, 100%. Darkness is your friend. Hello, darkness, my old friend. Yay! It's just so true. People are not prepared. They're all chasing the money. And they're going to get tired and fall down. And what I always try and pass along, especially to the youth I speak to, is that if you don't do something because you're waiting for someone else to do something about it, this is what's going to happen. The government and all those that want to keep you in shackles come for the artist. And when nobody says anything, the artist is gone. Then they come for the preacher, not the church preacher, the ones that are sharing this knowledge, the philosophers. And when no one does anything, the philosophers are gone. Then they're going to go for the elderly because they don't want us to have ancient knowledge and wisdom and experience from people that remember the way things were and the power that truly exists. And when nobody protects them, the elders are gone. And once they systematically have removed everyone else who keeps saying they're waiting for someone else, when they come for you and you call for help, no one is left because everybody was left waiting. The time to act is now. And it's not to fear monger you. It's not to scare you into, oh, don't you take this up. The best time to plant a tree is 20 years ago. The second best time to plant a tree is right now. When we succeed in sustainable communities, what proposals do you have for national operations? So I think, and this is a conversation that, or a conversation I've had with a lot of others, especially when I've sat in my role as an Indigenous leader with national, local, and especially Aboriginal leadership at those levels. My departure point is, I don't want to get caught only in the thought. I want to feel the thought, understand the thought, connect that thought energy to the actions required. Create the necessary habits and tasks that I need to commit myself to consistently do those actions and change my habits and develop new habits. Once I have reviewed my results and I've shared those with others, take in all the feedback from everyone else who's taken action, to see what changes I can implement, what things need to stay the same, and execute it again to replicate the result. Only once I have been able to successfully replicate the results am I able to think of scaling and expanding. And once I've done that, in itself, it will speak to those things. If we are going to say, yeah, we need to build a seed bank in all the communities, great. And then we talk, okay, but now how do we expand to the, we're going to start going down this, what if, and yes, we should, and scenario, and nothing gets done. Deal with national when we get to national. What's priority is local now. Local to you and your house, local to you and your neighbors and your community, and to your area in general. Everything starts within. Exactly. We need to go back to our roots and rediscover our power. All right. So I don't see anybody else that's looking to join as a guest, but thank you to everybody that jumped in. I'm going to quickly share the digital platform story. I want to share some information with you, especially if you're a South African. Currently, there are more. Where's my phone? Oh, man. I hope I've got no notes yet. There are more people connected to the internet than ever before. Ever before. There are more connected devices on average than there are people in this country. 56, 57 million, 60 million if you count the census. All of those people spend an average of about 14 hours online, scrolling, doing absolutely whatever it is that they are freely allowed to do.
Here we go.
In their own mind, in their own rights, they're allowed to do that. They are spending time on ads and tracking, social media advertising overview. Give me a second. Digital spend, main channels for online branch research, engagement with digital. 61.7%. of people year on year research brands before they look online. And this is why personal brand is important. Before you start talking about like, yeah, my business, how many of those posts, ads that talk only about the business and the business do you just scroll past? It's about personal. We are returning to the place where the people, the person, the living man and woman is the priority, not so much the business and the, but people are searching brands. 61% of people are searching brands. They are spending how many hours? Where's my hours? The consumer, digital payments, digital fitness and wellness, e-health, marketing spend. Oh, come on. Sorry, I've got my notes here and I can no biggie vroeg voor die tijd gegaan. They're spending, maybe I should share this in another view. 848 million mobile phones. There we go. 848 million mobile phones are connected to the internet at the moment. This is only for South Africa, hey, by the way. Just in South Africa. 17.9% of, that's the total change in people that have downloaded apps. That's plus 129 million app downloads. So if you've got an app or if you develop an app, that's what's there. The annual consumer spending digitally for South Africa alone is 244.8 million dollars every year. Every year. But we're living in poverty. We're living under the breadline. Where's the other one? Advertising search results. Man, there's quite a few other things I want to share with you, but I think I'll probably, so that it's a bit more, here we go, web traffic. Facebook sees 62.57% of those 550 million people that are connected on the internet. Twitter sees 9% of that traffic. Instagram sees 10%. The main priority, people are spending time on Facebook and on TikTok. That's where they are spending their time. And the types of accounts they are following are friends, family, and people that they know. TV shows or TV channels, actors, comedians, restaurants. Now you're like, Etienne, why are you telling me this stuff? If you don't know what to share, I'm like, I don't know what I'm going to put on the card. Talk about the things people are looking for. They don't need to pay you or you don't have to sell anything. When you share this information or this insight or this commentary on these things with people, their likes, their comments, their shares translate into the currencies that these platforms offer you. I have not earned my income from TikTok yet, but from all your likes and your quickies, I've got over like 150 rand in my account from TikTok that none of you sent me, but because you gave a harki, and what did that cost you? Oh, double tap. Because you made a comment, so that the platform realizes this content is of value because you share it with your network and other people, whether they know me or not, watch it. The platform says, hey, we got to incentivize these creators. We've got to incentivize these people that are on this platform to put more out because I, as TikTok, don't want to compete with Facebook and YouTube. I want to keep them here. So let me give this guy or this girl some cash. And I think I will explore this a little bit further. I have developed a program called the Dadfluencers Program, which is specifically targeting millennial fathers. No, it's not a course that you pay for. No, you don't have to buy anything from me. It is free knowledge you could have found anywhere else that I've curated for you. And if you want to, you can participate in it so that you can leverage this thing that has become part of your body. We're already cyborgs. You can't live your life without your cell phone. You can utilize it in a way so that it doesn't use you, to help you leverage your digital self or your digital straw man to then, if you don't have a bank account, you can still pay for things through this platform that you can then get from anywhere in the world. And I want to encourage you that the thing that scares you the most isn't the fact that I'm going to fail. The thing that scares you the most isn't the fact that you don't know what to do. The thing that scares you the most is, what is other people going to say? And what is it going to be when somebody comes and attacks me? Because they're going to attack you. They're going to talk shit about you. They're going to try to trip you up, because it's easy to point a finger from a static sit down position to criticize everybody and do nothing. But that fear is a red herring. What did they say in that Wolf of Wall Street? Fugazi, Fugazi. It's an illusion. It's not real. The only way that carries power is when you, like what a plasma say, you give it the energy, you transfer your energy, and somebody that hasn't seen the thing you haven't created or uploaded yet, that you in your head have said, yeah, they're going to judge me and they're going to say this and they're going to say that. You cannot say it's real until you've taken the action. I would encourage you. You're going to suck at the beginning. You're not going to know what to say at the beginning. You're not going to know what you're doing at the beginning. But that's exactly how your journey to becoming
a fully grown human being started. You didn't know how to peep, poop, eat, speak, none of those things, walk. But you took it one step at a time and you didn't give up when you fell down. You planted a flag, you learnt, and the next time the thing that tripped you up came up, you're like, not this time. Satan, the number you are calling is not available. Sorry, my ukulele is acting up. But that is something that I want to encourage you on. After your 100th video, you're an expert. And I'm not bragging here, but in a year of inconsistent posting, you haven't seen me, whether I have reached 1.8 million views. 1.8 million views. That's times that by two. 3.6 million eyes have seen something I've said. Not just my failures, but everything else, and carried on watching. And if everybody only watches, because it's easy to watch, this platform and others like it will pay you, because it is all about, say it with me, attention. Why do you think they say you have to pay attention? The true currency of all of these platforms is attention. I want to thank each and every one of you for joining me today. For those of you that might have missed it, or that might have been here sticky and couldn't have been here, this replay will be uploaded on YouTube. And for julle op YouTube wat nou hierdie ding kyk, sorry, ek het nou nie vir julle ook hallo gesê aan die begin nie, en vir julle ook ge-acknowledge, maar dankie vir al die subscriptions en die likes en die comments. Binne in die boxie in the replay is al die links van die references to where bartering comes from, why we moved to fiat currency, so you don't have to take my word for it, you can research it for yourself. I will also, in that link, I will place the, in that description box, I will place the link for my Dadfluencers community. So that if you want to, if you're a millennial father and you want to take your digital journey to start that, please do that. And then also, most importantly, do not stand in your own way because you're creating scenarios in your head. That is what's manifesting them. Everything starts as a thought before it materializes in this realm. You are more powerful and more capable than you think. You are much, much greater than even your biggest failure that has happened before you, because you are the author of your story. And that story, just like any TV series or any movie that you've ever watched, can change just like that. I appreciate, love you. I am grateful for you. And I give love, light, peace, and all prosperity to you, your family, and everyone that loves you back. Thank you for your comments. If I didn't get to all of them, I apologize. But please join me in the next one. Very important to remember, in my link, on my profile, Jural Assembly, talking about law and the birth certificate and all those other things that we were speaking about with High Commissioner Charles, they will be having that Zoom call for free tonight at 7. You can click on the link and go directly there. I appreciate, love you. Thank you. Have a wonderful day. Amase, taise are, taise kure, and bon voyage.